Hi, and welcome to County Talk. I'm your host, Kurt Pricer. During this segment of the budget edition of County Talk, we'll be talking about job positions within the county and merit increases for county employees who keep this county running for all of us. Joining me at the table is Joni Whitley, our Human Resources Director for Sarasota County, and Steve Botello, our Chief Financial Management Officer. Welcome to the show, both of you.
Thank you.
I'm going to start out with you, Joni, and a basic question here. What is a merit increase, and who amongst county staff is eligible to receive it?
Well, Kurt, a merit increase is annual increase, typically once a year, and it is based on performance. So what that means is not everyone gets it. It's based on performance. There's a rating scale from 1 to 5. And those employees that are meeting expectations, achieving, will get a merit increase this year.
So who is responsible for evaluating employees? Do they all come to you, or is it, we've got more than 2,000 employees here in Sarasota County, so are they all coming to you? I wouldn't think so.
No. That's actually the hiring managers, the managers for each department. They actually evaluate their employees on a standard performance evaluation system with expectations, and we also give them some guidance as far as we define the various rating levels, and it's actually a process that we roll out annually and work with the managers, but they perform the performance evaluations themselves.
When was the last time that we had this type of system, merit increases for staff?
The last time was actually about 4 years ago, 2009, and then for the managers, it's actually been about 5 years. So it's been 4 years, and for the majority of employees.
That would seem to fall in line with the way the economy has gone over the last 4 or 5 years as well. Nobody was getting raises, and the economy is now obviously starting to come back. Sarasota County is starting to look at retaining some of their employees and making sure that they're taken care of through merit increases. But just to make it clear, there's not a flat across the board raise for every Sarasota County employee, correct?
No, there is not. It's actually based on performance.
Okay. Now, Steve, the merit increases, what type of an impact might they have on the 2014 budget?
What's budgeted in the 2014 budget includes an up to a 3% merit increase. And that's for Board of County Commissioner employees only. So as you mentioned earlier, it's a little over 2,100 employees, and not all of those would be eligible. What we budgeted were for the non-bargaining units, and the total would be just under $2 million. And that's at a worst case. That's if everyone qualified based on their performance, which typically that's not going to be realistic. We will have employees that might not meet perfect expectation. So the final result won't be known until we go through the performance evaluations in the coming months. And again, not everyone would get the 3%. So what was budgeted was a little over $1.9 million, and a little less than half of that was within the general fund where our property tax revenues go into. Some of the other funds with budgeted merit increases are utilities, stormwater, solid waste, some of those funds and employees that get paid for by other revenue generated sources.
So when you and your staff make projections and you're looking at the budget and making projections, is it standard operating procedure for you to go ahead and make this type of projection, making the assumption or at least putting the number out there, this is what would happen if every employee got the 3% maximum?
Correct. We'd rather stay conservative to let the board know the worst case. So that's what we budget, and knowing that it wouldn't be a complete fiscal year of an increase, so this wouldn't really take effect until 1 month into the fiscal year. So as you stated, it's kind of standard operating procedures for the worst case, and ultimately when the final results are in, they will be under the $1.9 million that was budgeted.
Now, I mentioned a little over 2,000, you said about 2,100 full-time employees here in Sarasota County. But a lot of times when folks are watching the Board of County Commissioners during budget workshops or even during normal board meetings, they'll hear the term FTE. What is FTE? Most people think it's full-time employee, but that's not quite accurate, is it?
Yeah, full-time equivalent. So we reference them as FTEs. The way we track it, certain FTEs are budgeted amongst various departments and various funding sources. So it's a way that we can track how any one person is funded. Ultimately, too, the 2,100 positions, if you look up our total budget, it's a little closer to 3,400, because in the budget that the county commissioners adopts includes the sheriff's office, tax collector, property appraiser. So the Board of County Commissioner is over approximately 2,100, and the remaining 1,300 roughly are the elected and appointed officials.
And that can get a little bit confusing for people when they're watching, because the Board of County Commissioners are deciding the FY14 budget, but they're also voting on the budgets of some of the constitutional officers. But those people and their staffs in those offices don't work for the Board of County Commissioners. Is that correct?
Correct.
So how does this process work that the board actually has the responsibility for approving those budgets?
Yeah, it's just the way that our system is structured in the state of Florida and some of the budget guidelines. A lot of the elected appointed officials have to get carried through the county budget. So it's not unique to Sarasota County. There are some unique things we could do with funding certain appointed elected officials, but here in Sarasota County, the majority are budgeted within the general fund and rolled into our countywide budget that the board adopts in September of each year.
Now, Joni, those employees that are in the constitutional offices, are they also following the same process of the merit increases, so are they in the same system? So are those employees, non-bargaining employees, I'm assuming, but are those employees that are non-bargaining in constitutional, are they on the same curve with the 3% evaluation process?
No, they actually have their own process. They don't fall under our performance management system.
Okay, but so they do.
It's up to each constitutional officer to determine that which system they're going to use.
And how about HR responsibilities? So, but do they rely on your office, or do they have their own HR departments as well?
They have their own HR departments. Oh. But we do talk back and forth, and we kind of make sure that we're aligned and similar in our systems.
Okay, so where we are right now with about 2,100 employees, how does our workforce compare to where we've been in years past? Are we smaller? Are we bigger? Where are we trending? Steve?
We're much smaller. This year, we have some increases, and that's largely attributable to the board wanting to increase level of services. An example would be our parks. The board put a focus on getting some of our parks and the ball fields up to a better quality, and also with the mowing of our roadways. So we have an internal crew that can now complement some of the contractors. So we have grown, but we're still approximately 300 positions less than we were going back 5 or 6 years. So we did make a lot of reductions, and not all of those were filled positions. We dropped a lot of vacant positions, but in total, approximately 300 positions.
Okay. I want to thank both of you for joining me here at the table today on County Talk. I'd also like to thank our viewers for joining us here on County Talk. Now, you can visit our website at scgov.net for show times, or you can subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. Just click the link on the bottom of the webpage at scgov.net. Thank you for watching County Talk. We'll see you next time.